Hello everyone and welcome back to another edition of West Ham Fan TV's Post-Match Punt, the only West Ham United post-match full show on the internet. We've just been to the West Ham Man City game. It's West Ham 2, Manchester City 2. Boys, that was some fucking close. Too close.
Yeah.
We was unlucky. Really unlucky. Let's go for the starting lineup.
I must admit, I've never walked away being disappointed with a draw.
Especially against St. Man City.
What happens when you draw against like Exeter then? You disappointed or not?
It's us, isn't it? I'm used to that.
Hang on, Graham's going to come out of a stat now from about 10 years.
Yeah. I believe in that. It's about 1933, I think. Yeah, anyway.
Well done, Graham. Oxford.
Let's go through the starting lineup. Jenkinson out. Jenkinson plays instead of Tompkins. Tompkins was out, wasn't he?
Mm-hmm. I felt a bit sorry for Ogbonna that he got dropped today.
Yeah, I was the same as well.
I was a bit surprised, but Reid and Collins looked solid today.
Mm.
Yeah.
Yeah, Alex Reedy Song stepped in.
Oh, the God. Wet wipe.
Jesus, man. That guy was class today.
Yeah, he did play well.
That was absolute top class.
It was the Alex Song of the first half.
Yeah.
He had his swagger back. You see it. He just bossed the whole game.
David Tillman, I've got a sniff.
Mm, and good as well. Mm. I was worried about him today because he always plays well against West Ham.
Yeah. Who else? Jelovic kept it. Valencia kept his place up front, and I thought to myself, I'll be honest, when I saw that team who's coming in, I thought, oh, we're going to have no distribution again, no one to hold up the ball.
See, I was different when I see the starting lineup and I see Valencia up front. I thought, yeah, that's a good decision.
Mm.
I thought it'd have been better playing Jelovic up front.
It's just the way Valencia played last
week.
That's
because he was non-existent last week.
Yeah, but then everyone was. I don't think he could have made like wholesale changes. You know, it just maybe one or two players.
It's because of his touch as well.
Yeah,
you know what I mean.
His touch was awful last week.
It's been awful all the time. But fucking hell, he stepped up today. Let's go through the game then. Starts off a cracking start, like a firecracker. We come out the traps. We were saying last week, we've got to come out of the traps, Jesus Christ, couldn't come out of the traps.
What was it, about 30, 40 seconds?
45 seconds, yeah.
55, they said on.
It's the second fastest goal of the Premier League.
Is it?
Yeah.
I
don't know whether that's altogether or that's this season.
Probably this season, because I think someone scored about 18 seconds before, didn't they?
Mm. It was really fast.
We come out of the traps, man.
Scored a few goals this year, though, in quite a few games.
No, but I think sometimes we get, you know, there's been a lot of times this season where we just don't start. Last week was a prime example. Mm-hmm. We just didn't start last week. We found ourselves 2-0 down before we got out of the changing room.
Yep.
Yeah, but that's when you take it in context of the rest of the season. Last week was a one-off. I mean, it was just a poor game from everyone.
I think we've had a couple of games. I wouldn't say it's a one-off.
Mm.
It's just another one of them kicks up the arse.
We've had games like that this season, but we've come back in it.
Maybe the Watford game, we was bad,
but you can't take it away from Newcastle last week. They was just decent in the start. They weren't great,
yeah,
but they was decent.
They started really well last week.
Yeah.
Like we said, we just didn't come out of the dressing room.
No.
Yeah.
But that's what I was a bit worried, because I was thinking to myself, you know, you don't come out of the dressing room this week, you're going to find yourself 3 or 4 nil down by the time.
They had to be up against City today, and they was straight from kick-off, and then 1-0 up, couldn't ask for a better start. Joe Hart should have done better.
For the goal? Yeah, I said that.
Should have done better.
It come at him fast,
that.
Though.
Yeah.
It come at him quick.
But it's great, Valencia in the right position.
Yeah, he dropped off well as well. I thought, you know, that's a touch of a good player when you can anticipate that it's gonna, you know, that's a bit of anticipation. Knew someone was in the back post. He wasn't sliding in the front. He was sort of like dropped back just in case.
Yeah.
And you know, it dropped to him and lovely finish. Yeah. I thought lovely, beautiful finish. First
great,
time.
Great little run by Kyoto.
Yeah, and that
he burst into the box. I think Song made the tackle.
That's him of old, though, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
That's what Song gives him.
I was just about to say, did you notice this difference with them three in the middle today? Noble, Kiele and Song.
I said to you, Noble's better when he's got them players alongside him, and he's got Song alongside him, because he can get on with his...
I've been saying that since the opening day of the season.
When you look back at that game, you see Song, he sits He sits just in front of the back four and behind them two.
Yeah.
And he allows them two to get forward.
He was world class today.
Yeah. Outstanding.
No
absolutely outstanding.
Bones about it, mate. He was world class. He was back to the very best Alex Song, Arsenal Alex Song.
Yeah.
He was world class today. I can't, you know, I was thinking, like, because Payet had a real good game as well, and I was thinking to myself, ah, the sponsor's going to give him it. Because,
but he stepped up.
No, so we come out, 1 minute in, we, you know, we're dominating the game. I think, to be honest, I think we dominated the whole thing.
Yeah.
The whole thing from first minute to... They had spells, but they're going to have spells. You know what I mean? They've got some... that Aguero, we talk about him, he's just an enigma. He's a different class.
He's a great player.
I think he's the best player in the Premier League.
I'll agree with that. He just does things that, like... You know, some of the things he gets to shouldn't be getting there. Do you know what I mean? Like, the way he takes it round players and...
He always looks like he's injured all the time, the way he just strolls around. But, listen, great players score goals and win your games and rescue your points.
The thing is, you take him out of that side today, they didn't really pose a threat.
I thought we'd done well today. We kept Kevin De Bruyne and Silva very quiet. Yaya Toure... We sort of kept him quiet, but he still made things happen.
But that's the difference. So them players, you know, that's quality players, and to keep the two of them quiet.
Yeah.
You know, it's not.
And
you know,
we controlled the game up to the moment, and the penalty. I mean,
Where I was sitting, it looked like a shoulder barge. From where I was sitting in the booking up, I was far away. It looked like it was just. But someone told me that he jinxed.
Yeah, our first reaction from our. Where we were sitting, it looked like he took the ball, but then it filtered through that it was a penalty.
Yeah,
it
took him.
It was unfortunate.
It was given, but maybe it was one of them ones that may be given, maybe not given. I don't know.
Like you say, if it had been us down the other end, would you have been screaming for a penalty?
Yeah, probably. But
to be fair on that, let's play from the referee today. If it was us down the other end, he wouldn't have given it.
No, I was just about to say that. What do you make the referee?
I'm surprised that Yaya Toure, it took that long for him to get booked. Was in the 86th minute.
That tackle,
one when he brought down Kyoto. Yeah.
He should have walked.
He shouldn't have walked.
He should have had at least.
He should have got a yellow.
From what I've heard on the replay, he should have walked.
No, he had players behind him. He wasn't the last man.
No, it was just the way. It was the way he went in.
The way he went in from behind.
I didn't think it was that bad.
I've seen Noble get sent off for less.
Yeah, I know, but
so no.
But he should have had two yellow cards anyway.
Yeah. He should have been booked for that.
There was a couple of times, even one when he went up studs up and he got Kyoto. He couldn't handle
today. That was the thing, and that's the only way he tried to handle him, by manhandling him.
Trying to put him out of the game. Yeah.
Good penalty. Good finish.
It was a great. Yeah, I mean, he's never going to miss that, is he? Let's be honest. No. He's too good to miss that. Anyway, come back out again. I thought they had a little bit of a spell after that. Before the penalty, and then we come out again, all guns blazing. I think. The rest of the half, I thought we was the better side.
Yeah, I can't remember too many clear cuts. The only one I can remember was the free kick.
No, the Aguero.
Aguero before the penalty.
Oh, yeah.
Post. Oh, mate. And then I thought he'd done it. I called
chest
it.
Down.
But then that was Adrian as well. Adrian done that a couple of times today. He rushed out without talking to his defenders.
Do you know what I think he was trying to do? I think he was trying to psych him out. I think he was trying to rush then retreat.
Yeah, but, unlucky from Aguero. Yeah. If that had gone in, you'd have had to applaud that.
It hit the post and just drops. Yeah. And then there's Reid like chesting it back, and he's just sitting there thinking, are him and Adrian on the same wavelength? But luckily enough, they weren't. But it just shows the confidence in the players that Reid's got that confidence to chest it to his goalkeeper on the fucking goal line.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, and he knows his goalkeeper's going to be there.
But hang on, we've missed something out. Sam Byram coming on.
No, that was after. That was before the penalty. The chip was before the penalty, weren't it?
Yeah. He went off after the goal. Cause
sorry, I thought he was on about.
Anyway, Jenkinson gets injured, goes down. I don't know what happened to him.
It looked like a knee problem.
Do you know what it looked like?
For me, it looked like he could have carried on.
Yeah,
at one point.
I exactly said that to him because he went over to the side and it looked like Bilic was getting a sub on. I was going, hold on a minute, he's all right. He got up and he was like, looked a bit confused, but I think that's just his face. I don't think it was like.
He always looks knackered to me. Like,
but he ran off.
He did have a slight limp.
A slight limp, Scott. Yeah.
But the thing is, you don't know if he's tweaked a knee.
We'll see anyway, won't we?
Without a track record, next run he probably would have took his leg.
Do you honestly want to know what I think? I don't think he fancied it.
No, I don't think he fancied it.
I don't think he fancied it.
Yeah, I think he was up for it. I said I do think he was injured.
I was quite pleased he started, to be honest.
So was I.
Yeah, I said the same thing. I'd rather have had him today than Tompkins at right back, just for their pace.
Exactly.
But, no, it was a shame he went off, but Sam Byram come on, and he didn't look out of place.
To be fair,
2 minutes he was on that pitch and he chested it down and smashed it 40 yards to Payet's chest. And that's confidence.
Well, was it Payet smashed it in 40 yards, didn't he? Yeah. And he just took it, bosh, peed it back. And then Payet messed it up.
I don't think he'd done anything wrong, Sam Byram, today.
Not at all.
No.
He didn't look right. He stepped up, and you're stepping up from marking fucking who plays in Michael Dubry
played about 20 years ago
whoever, but and then now you're marking Sergio Aguero.
Not a bad debut to make, is it?
He would have probably been this earlier this season or last season would have probably been marking Antonio.
Yeah, true.
I mean, you got two championship, like ex-championship players down that right and that first and second half, and they didn't do nothing wrong.
No.
I thought Antonio, but going back to Byram, I mean, looks even to looking at one day, I mean, Everton fans are going to have a fucking feel, like they're going to be crying in their cornflakes tomorrow, I think. But let's talk. Do you know what? Let's talk about a little bit about what's been said in the week with the Everton fans before we move on to the games, because we're talking about Sam Byram. Martinez coming out and saying, what did he say? He weren't the player for us.
Yeah. What it is, look, this is what sums it up with Everton. Everton were in for him. Their fans were on Twitter going, oh yeah, we've signed him, Sam Byram this, Sam Byram that.
Because he
chose us, which he was always going to do if we come in for him. Mm. And now all Everton fans are saying, we didn't want him. He would have just been a backup. Blah, 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 blah. Ogbonna would have been a backup. Payet would have been a backup.
The biggest load of bollocks I've ever heard in my life.
Their fans are getting worse than Spurs. I don't know what their problem is lately. They're obviously a club that's always going to be in Liverpool's shadow. They see a club like us moving on to things, and they don't like it.
New stadium.
Players coming to us.
Yeah.
You know? Fuck yeah. Everton.
You look at
Everton really fucking doing my head in lately.
You look at the transfers of old, the players that have gone there. Chose there over us. You know,
they keep banging on about Lukaku.
Do you know what it is? I'll be honest with you. I know exactly what it is. They were a massive club. Mm. They were a massive club back in the 80s. Yeah, they were massive. I get reminded every day on Twitter now. 9 league titles.
So was Michael Jackson, but he's dead now. Fuck it, we're not in the 80s now. Yeah, Liverpool were big in the 70s and 80s.
No, yeah, but this is what I'm about to say. That was massive, right? Now, they probably had a state-of-the-art ground at the time. Mm. You know, tons of league titles, tons of FA Cups and all this, winning trophies and all that. Since then, since 95, when they scraped a trophy against Man United, luckily at Wembley, since the 80s, they've just got a decline now. Let's be honest, they've got a chairman with no money.
Mm-hmm.
They've got a ground that's falling apart. Mm. And then they see someone like us, who traditionally have been seen below them, yeah, sort of like advancing, got a brand new stadium. Even they say Upton Park's better than him. Yeah, it's better than their ground, and we're knocking it down.
Yeah.
Shows you how far we're getting forward instead of them. And they just can't take it. They can't take that people would think we're a better club now. You know what I mean? But the same would be said about Leeds and
every club has their period.
Forest,
Leeds were big in the 60s.
Ipswich won European cups and fucking Derby. Forest. Aston Villa have won European. Honest,
Chelsea were poor until Abramovich came in.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Preston have got league titles.
Yeah,
division league title.
Yeah,
that doesn't mean nothing.
The eighties are 30 years ago now. Get over it. Stop wearing shoulder pads and pulling out them massive mobile phones and move into the 2000s.
No, that is just Liverpool.
Yeah. Anyway,
honestly, like a lot of clubs, they keep going on about, oh, we're getting a new shiny stadium. So what? So fuck you. I'm not being funny, but they're going on about their taxes. But no, Scouser pays taxes, so they're not paying. They're not paying for our stadium.
I'm fed up.
I will get comments because I'm fed up with all these people and all these fans always going on about us. Any club, Man City have been in their stadium deal. Since 2003.
They had a similar deal to us.
Who's been saying anything to them?
Like we've said on many occasions.
Don't worry about us.
Yeah. Forget about us. Thank Barry Earn and Tottenham. for the tax.
Yeah, we wanted to pay it, mate. We were going to buy it.
Exactly. So thank them too. They fucked it up.
Fed up. Get over people it. Always having dig at our club. They need to worry about their own club.
And at the end of the day, I'm paying for that ground. You're paying for that ground. You're paying for that ground. So we're paying for it as well.
Mm. We're taxpayers.
Yeah, exactly.
Anyway, he had a good debut.
Very good.
Really good debut. And I'm pleased.
Yep.
I'm so pleased. He looked like he'd been playing there for years.
I think him and Creswell getting up and.
No, I don't think. Do you know what I liked about him today? Is he never. Any time he felt pressured, he went back to Collins.
Yep.
Any time, you know, he was a bit under a bit of pressure, he played the way he was facing. He didn't try nothing fancy, apart from that outrageous 40-yard ball.
But he still pulled it off.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah. But he tried nothing fancy. He looked so comfortable there. Mm.
The thing for me is,
I'm looking forward to seeing him in the future.
Mm. Yeah,
I think we could see him start.
I think so.
The next league game. I don't think he can play in the FA Cup, can he?
He might not be able
to. I think he played for Leeds. But the next league game could start.
I don't think Jenkinson might not get a look in there.
Well, you know, if he's injured, he's going to be out for a few weeks.
Mm. The thing is with Jenks, I don't know what's happening with that, because we obviously played Arsenal 1.5 million up front for him. And now they want to take him back, but they won't give us half the money back, which is fair. We might as well keep him.
Yeah,
I don't understand what that deal is, but it wouldn't surprise me if he goes back to Arsenal.
Please, if you
I'll
go,
give Byron a couple more weeks to see.
Yeah, you've got until the end of obviously January.
And the problem is,
he can go back any time, can't he?
Probably, yeah.
Loan deal, yeah.
But the problem we've got again is the depth, isn't it? You know, if we send Jenks back and Tompkins injuries.
Yeah.
Well, according to Billich, Jenks ain't going nowhere, so.
So just keep him there. You know, it's a good backup to have. If Byram does hit the ground running as he has this today.
Let's be honest, he's not a backup to Byram, is he? Byram should be a backup to him.
But that's it. If Byram now hits a bit of form, keep playing him.
Yeah, these are exciting times anyway. Anyway, end of the first half. I mean, there was nothing really happened for the rest of it, did it?
Yeah.
What happened?
Yeah, world class safe and free.
Oh, God, yeah, I forgot about. Oh, fucking hell, I forgot about the sending off. I forgot about everything. Hold on a minute, yeah. So, a couple minutes later, someone puts the ball through. Was it Payet? Put it through to him, or was it Song?
Song, I think.
I think Song put it through to Antonio. Antonio's knocked it past Otamendi.
Clear in the corner. If I remember rightly, Man City had a corner, weren't it?
Yeah, maybe.
And it was on the counter attack. And the ball's. We played the ball out from the back, it's gone through to.
I can't remember.
Antonio.
Anyway, yeah, he's played it through to Antonio. Antonio's knocked it past Otamendi, threw on goal, brings him down.
Yep.
What happened? Referee bottled it.
Yeah.
Absolutely bottled it. And I think, to be honest with you, today, right, and I'm not just saying this about because I'm bitter or whatever, you know what I mean? A point against Man City is a great point.
Yep.
But. I feel robbed by him, because he was fucking awful, that referee.
He bowled a lot of decisions today. Yeah. Like I said, Toure should have had two yellow cards today.
Yep.
Yeah. Easy.
I think the standard referee has been poor all season, in general, not just our games, in general.
Like, but that when he booked Noble for that challenge, Noble got the ball.
Yeah.
Exactly.
But that's what I'm saying, like, you bring him down, last man, booking. And Byron got booking for fuck all as well.
So his second foul, he got booked.
Yeah.
Mm. And I'm sure Toure made four or five. More before he got booked.
That Byron one, I turned around to the boat next to me and I said, he'd have got away with that in the Championship. That's the difference between Championship football and Premier League football. You can't get away with that, but he's still never been booked.
It's just I think it was a disgraceful referee. I think the linesman was the same.
You saw the linesman on our side.
Wouldn't give anything.
He hesitated every time to give a decision. Mm. And probably. What, after decisions he gave for the wrong decision?
Mm.
He was absolutely awful.
Mm.
And they said the referee was no better.
I just think it's been awful this year.
That
Premier League
Payet free kick though, Joe Hart, what a save. I thought we hit a crossbar at first from where I was sitting, because I'm behind that goal, and it looked like he had a crossbar. When I see the replay,
that was such a great save.
That was,
and then he done one just after that where someone crossed it, and it was dropping to Valencia's feet, and he scooped it out and made sure it went.
His critics, but he's a world class goalkeeper.
I wouldn't call him a world class goalkeeper. I wouldn't call him a world class goalkeeper.
He's the best we've got in this country.
Best we've got in the country, without a doubt.
I know you say like he has his moments,
but what goalkeeper don't?
you know, he pulls off some
De Gea has his moments,
world class saves,
and he's world class. Everyone says he's world class. Yeah. Lloris, everyone says he's world class. He has his moments.
It's like Scott said, you know, 9 times out of 10 you make a mistake in goal, it's in the back of the net. So he might only make one mistake, but
I don't know. Sometimes I just think he gets a little bit. It looks like to me he's showing off too much sometimes.
Big-headed, doesn't he?
Yeah,
that's his problem.
And that's when he starts to. So he's been dropped for Man City for doing that sort of thing. He just gets a bit above himself, bit confident, bit cocky.
It's the same when you go back to when he was playing for England under 21s. We're in the semi-final, he's penalty shootout.
Yeah,
you know,
Sweden,
he gets booked and gets suspended for the final for, you know, doing things he shouldn't be doing, just getting there and getting on with the game. You know, and it's just that is it. He thinks he's a bit above himself.
Yeah.
And lets himself down. But you see that with some players quite a lot.
He's, don't get me wrong, he's a very good goalkeeper. Very good goalkeeper. Like, but I wouldn't call him world class, because like I've seen world class goalkeepers like Buffon.
That was world class.
And you've never seen them make mistakes?
Not really. Not like him.
They all make mistakes.
Buffon, I think, was a different level as a goalkeeper.
I mean,
that's world class.
Yeah. He was a different level to a lot of goalkeepers, though, Buffon.
He didn't make many mistakes. I mean, one or two in his career.
Like, all his career, he was. You know, number one at Madrid in Spain, like, and he's, you know, last couple of seasons he's been dropping a few.
Yeah, then Real Madrid were slating him, calling him shit.
Yeah.
Yeah, so.
No, I wouldn't say he was world class. Sorry to disagree with you, mate.
We've all got opinions. I think Joe Hart is a good goalkeeper.
Yeah, very good goalkeeper. But, so that was it for the first half.
If you look at Arsenal.
Have I missed anything?
No, that's it. But you look at that, though, if it weren't for him and the poor decision.
But that is, you know, that's where a goalkeeper can come into, you know. He was very good today. I think Adrian wasn't at his best. He done things right, but he said he made a few rash decisions today when he could have stayed on his line. Like, it could have cost us, but it didn't. But you know, I'm never going to have a go at Adrian because he saves us so many times.
He didn't really have a lot to do in the
first half,
did he?
Well, not a great amount. No, yeah. I don't remember him making a save.
No, I can't.
When
you look at the chances, they had a penalty and then the one hit the post in the first half. But I can't remember him having to pull off a save.
They didn't
at
have
all.
Any like clear cut chances, did they?
Yeah, so second half, come out in the same manner, just absolutely bombarding them, just chance after chance after chance. Didn't, what I would say in the first half, we didn't make our chances count enough against them. You know, as you said, they did keep, but you know, we could have been away by then. And then second goal, I couldn't believe it. I thought play had stopped.
Yeah,
that's God's honest truth. Because
quick thinking from Antonio.
Great quick thinking from Antonio. Brilliant quick thinking. A great throw as well. Yeah. I mean, that's as good as a.
And not only that, it was good for Valencia to get his body in front of the defender to not make him get the ball.
Valencia was,
and that was a good finish.
Yeah,
I don't remember the last time I see a goal from a throw in.
No.
I don't think I ever have.
We ain't had a player that can sling a ball like that.
These throw-ins are better than corners, isn't they?
Mm.
They're better than crosses, isn't they?
He gets so much power and spin on them.
Our corners don't.
Because the thing is, it's not like he just loops them up into the air.
He was like Rory Delap used to do for pace and power.
But that's all they used to do. They used to play for throw ones, man. They used to piss me off.
Yeah, but the thing is, like, if you've got someone that can do that and whip it in,
all right when you get a throw in and it can be done, but not play for them, right? Not like fucking chip them into touch like fucking rugby players and hoping.
Be fair, Delap used to, no matter what side of the pitch it was on, he'd take the throw. At least with us, it's only when they're on Antonio's side.
Yeah.
I suppose if we're chasing a goal towards the end of a game, he may then take it from another side. But
and another great finish as well. Yeah. It was nice and cool. He took his time.
Well, like Ryan said, he used his body in front.
Yeah.
I'm surprised the ref didn't blow up for a free kick.
I'll be honest with you.
I'm surprised.
I think that was the best game I've seen him in the West Ham shirt.
Over there.
I totally agree.
Yeah, he played really well.
Another two guys. Four goals in three games. Never scored a year before he scored for Bournemouth.
Yeah.
That's all they need, a bit of confidence, and that'll do him a world of good today.
But that's fantastic, isn't it? Because, you know, he stepped up when the others are out, and now they're coming back. The future's still good for us, man. I'm telling you what, we're in the distance. We're in touching distance. If we can, as I said before, we'll talk about this at the end transfers, but it looks like we've got another couple of players coming in.
Which is good.
Which is good. Yeah, just for cover and just for backup and different options, which I think is a fantastic.
Well,
thing.
One striker we're linked with, if we get him, I don't see him being a backup. I can see him being our main striker.
Emenike.
No, Yilmaz.
Yilmaz. I'm hearing Emenike.
That's who I heard him.
Yeah, but well, we'll talk about that at the end anyway. But 2-2. We was controlling the game.
2-1.
2-1. Sorry, we was controlling the game.
Yeah. Give the ending away now.
Ruin the film. Nah, yeah. But the thing is, like I said, with Aguero,
that's the sign of
a world-class striker, when you can be quiet for 20, 30 minutes, not do nothing, and then bang.
I didn't see it properly, but it looked lucky to me.
Yeah, it was.
Before we talk about that, I want to talk about the substitution.
As I said to you when he made it, I do not
Antonio calls Clichy and it was Kolarov, wasn't it, right back? He calls them all sorts of problems. He had another fantastic game. I was saying to him, he's looking more and more like a Premier League player every week.
Yeah, he's improving every week.
Yeah, and I didn't think he had that in him.
No.
But I was too quick to judge him. I said, he's not going to learn that. He's not going to learn that. And every week he looks stronger and stronger and stronger. And
he looked like the player who we signed.
Yeah, he just was hassling them all game.
Didn't give him a chance,
didn't give him a sniff, didn't give him anything, right? And after 65 minutes, he brings him off and brings Moses on.
See, I thought it was the right decision to bring Moses on, because I thought with his pace, he had a good game at City earlier in the season. He's just come back. I thought, yeah, but then taking Antonio off at that time was a bit too early for me. I did want Moses on to cause them problems with his
pace. For me, he strolled around and done fuck all.
Yeah, but
When Moses came on, we were playing with 10 men.
Yeah, he strolled around and done nothing.
He was the other week.
Yeah, a bit like that. He's another one.
He weren't as bad as Zerati, but he just was. He
had a couple of good runs and that. But
he didn't want to know when he lost the ball.
Nah,
he went tracking back.
He jogged back.
But against City, that's what you need. That's what you need. He should have come on for the last 10.
Yeah, that was it. I think he'd come on 10 minutes too early for me. Looking at it in hindsight, like before we saw how he performed when he came on. Like you said, you would have brought him on, but it would have been last 20, last 15.
Do you know what I would have done as well? I know he had to chuck Jelovic on at the end just to give us a different option and whatever, but I would have taken... Noble done a lot of work in there today. He done a lot of work in there, done some good stuff, some not-so-good stuff. I would have just taken him off and put Obiang on just for that no-nonsense approach to it. Do you know what I mean? Like, Noble, as much as the good work he does, sometimes he gets a bit carried away with it. You know what I mean? Because he's a fan, I think when, like, the tackles are... Do you agree with me? Yeah. When the tackles are flying, he wants to get to everything.
Yeah.
And, like, he ain't got the body to get to everything. He ain't got the ability to get to him, but he wants to.
Yeah.
And that's great, but I would have just... let's slow it down now. Let's calm it down. Keep hold of the ball.
I think Obiang would have been a good player to bring in into that middle.
Yeah.
You know, just to solidify that middle up.
Yeah. Because Alex Song wasn't letting anything get past him.
No. As you said, he was immense.
I'll tell you what today's game was screaming out for. Andy Carroll.
We said that. Yeah.
Without a doubt. I was sitting there thinking to myself, if he was there or on that bench, bringing him on with 10 minutes ago, we'd have won that game.
The ball Byron put in the first half.
Ball Noble put in.
Just missed like Valencia. The ball Noble put in the second half. The one, was it Antonio or headed it wide? They're the chances that Carroll screamed out for.
You
put that on to Carroll, it's a goal. 9 times out of 10, it's a goal.
He'd just clean everyone out to get to it, wouldn't he?
Yeah, he'd probably been given free kicks against the fucking referee today. You know, when he had to smell one of their farts, and he'd have been given free. You know what I mean? It's fucking ridiculous.
I can't remember any more chances. The only one was right at the end.
We didn't talk about Aguero's goal though.
Delph hit the post.
I thought that was a bit lucky though. I felt Adrian had it covered as well. Yeah. I didn't think.
Yeah,
it
didn't hit the post clean. It sort of clipped the post. Yeah. So that weren't.
But for me though, see the amount of time all Man City were doing was going long over the top to Aguero.
One thing as well, Winston Reid's tackle on De Bruyne when De Bruyne went through and Reid got back, and that was a great tackle. He played really well today. I think he's cemented his spot back in that team now. It's just out of Ogbonna and Collins.
But Collins didn't put a foot wrong today.
No, the only thing I worry about with Collins is someone like Aguero. I thought he was going to give a lot of free kicks away today. But fair play to him. He got stuck in.
Just won every header.
Yeah, just typical Ginger Pele this season.
We've got four decent centre halves now.
Yeah.
You know, so there's good cover.
Piatt was class.
So I'm saying Piatt.
He took the fucking.
That's the thing.
There was £50 million men on the pitch, and he outshone every single one of them.
And
apart from Alex Song,
he was. This is the thing. He was good. He had a good game, but Song was so good. It just made Piatt look normal.
I thought Piatt today, as good as he played, there was a couple of times where he tried a bit too much.
Yeah, you're going to get...
There was one time where he could have put Kiyote through on the right.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
He decided to go more, try to do a step over again and lost the ball.
Yeah.
But look, I'm not going to sit here and slag him off. He's world class. And
he's the thing that you pay your money to see.
He's better than Dan.
Exactly. Totally agree with you.
He is. Super Slammers man. They were singing his name today, weren't they? Super Slam.
Someone's putting out a t-shirt.
Fucking hell, every week. Every week.
Dan.
Get the legends rage.
We go back to Moses.
Collins one coming out soon.
If we go back to Moses, it's his fault we conceded that second goal.
Yeah.
Because he's got the ball. Criswell's gone past him on the overlap, gone through. He stops, turns around and goes backwards when there was no need to.
And also I think Collins and Reid got a bit mixed up as well.
Yeah.
But it just seemed to bounce around a lot before it fell to him.
But it was Criswell's now out of position. The ball was forward. Moses has stopped and gone backwards.
But that's the thing about Man City though, isn't it? One mistake and they're on you. You know what I mean?
That's a sign of a team that are going for the title. And when you've got players like Aguero on the pitch, it's a privilege to see players like that in the flesh, you know what I mean?
It's what we want to see.
It's probably what players want to play against as well.
I can't wait for him to be in the claret and blue next season at the Olympic Stadium.
I said to him, can you imagine Aguero in our side?
No. Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
That ain't never happened, Scott.
It'd probably be sucked.
That won't happen, but, you know.
Yeah, the bitch will be up front. Yeah. But it was just a disappointment. I just felt robbed, you know what I mean? I felt a bit robbed today because I definitely felt Otamendi should have gone. And, you know, 10 men's a different game. We just had the better of them all game with 11.
If Torre gets the booking that he should have got, he's off in the second half as well.
That's the difference with this season and the last few seasons. You're coming out of there today disappointed with a 2-2 draw against Man City at home.
Taking 4 points off them.
Yeah. I remember the days when they used to get 4 points.
Yeah, the number of days they used to be as 3-0 and we won't even get a sniff.
Nah.
And now we've gone to their ground.
Well, look at the Carling Cup semi-final.
Ground this season. We beat them 2-1. All right, we held on for the second half. And then today, we could have walked out with another 3 points.
We should have.
And I think hardcore Man City fans would have probably held their hands up and say, yeah, we deserve to win that, West Ham.
Yeah.
Not Man City, like West Ham.
We at the bar at the end, Kyoto.
And that's just great chance right here in Kyoto. I thought, Jesus Christ, I thought, no, just that had gone in, mate. I think the old Trevor Brooking up would have just gone collapsed over, like.
Just got too much on it, didn't
he? Yeah. And it was literally the last touch of the game, as soon as that went, the ref blew.
Nah, just gutted, man. But it's another point.
Four points. We're disappointed.
I know Tottenham won today. We're a point off of Man United, and they were fucking shit today.
And not only that,
and
right, you think
Southampton,
Charlie Austin. But the thing is, like, it's another top team that we haven't lost again. We've done a double over Liverpool. We've beat Man City and drew at home. We've got Arsenal coming up, you know.
But again, we're starting. This is the good thing about it, right? We're starting to make this a fortress.
Yeah.
I think this is the best run of undefeated games we've had there since '97.
Mm. Redknapp days, yeah.
Yeah, since '97. I remember only losing there twice.
Well, the thing is, still going by it, Bournemouth are the last team to win at the bowling. After we lost them first two games, I thought to myself, this is going to be this one of these seasons where we're not going to hardly win here. But we ain't lost since August at home.
That's it.
You know, a lot of draws, but at times when we was on our arse. But this is the thing.
Draw than lose.
You have City out of the way now. Got Liverpool in a cup, which no matter what happens, I want to go for the FA Cup, so he should definitely put out a decent team.
But I think he will.
That's a rest from the league now.
Yeah.
And the next week, Lanzini's going to be back. The week after that, Carroll's going to be back. Mm. The week after that, Sacco's going to be back.
And whatever we had in
the transfer window.
Yeah, so squad available.
It's all looking cushy because don't forget, we've got still Tottenham to play there. The last game under the lights at the bowling, do you think they're going to lose that? Because I don't.
Well, the thing is, as well, you look at the next few league games, Southampton, they're a bit 50-50. Always a tough game there. Then you've got Aston Villa, Norwich. You know, they're games that we can win.
Of course they are. They're all winnable games.
If we
they're
win,
all winnable games.
We're in touching distance.
Yeah.
When these players start coming back, we get our full squad back. If they all stay fit, of course, you don't know what happens.
This is what's
going to help us as well. The last games at the bowling, we're down to the last eight games at the bowling now. Eight games left, right? They're not going to want to lose here. It's going to start creeping into their mind now, right? We ain't lost here since August. Let's fucking get this season and let's make sure we do not lose here again to anybody, right?
But then that could work the other way.
Yeah, that's on their mind.
You don't want
to
lose.
I think once you get into that frame of mind and you're undefeated, you've got a streak of confidence as well. Yeah, and you've had,
I think if we can get past Liverpool in the cup, I think there's nothing stopping us this season.
There's nothing stopping us anyway.
No,
we can still break into that top six, five.
I think Liverpool.
I think top four is a bit too much.
We've got to play Spurs, though.
Liverpool.
But I'm just saying, I don't think they'll be top four either. But I'm just saying,
I think they will.
Liverpool's going to be a tough game next week. You know, I know we've done the double over them and we seem to have their number this season, but it's going to be a tough game. I hope we don't lose. I don't think we will. I'm confident we're going to.
I've got a feeling we're going to pull them back here.
After watching Liverpool last couple of games, like especially today, they won 5-4 against Norwich.
They're weak at set pieces.
Yeah, they're weak everywhere.
Four goals against Norwich.
They're weak everywhere.
You know, the only decent defender they've got, Saka.
We could go up. Yeah, and that says it all.
Yeah,
we could go up there next week and another 3-0 win.
Of course we could.
Easy.
We just. I'd be more confident if we had Lanzini and Carroll available. I'm still confident.
But then the week after that, we will have.
Yeah.
I sound like fucking. What's his name? Denzel Washington. Yeah. No, not Denzel Washington. Jay-Z.
It is exciting. It's exciting. You can't remember this. I'm naked, mate. You can't remember this time. I can't remember this time I've been that excited getting towards the end of the season. Apart from
I got excited at Christmas last year, and then we dropped off. This season, it doesn't look like we're letting up.
And that's the difference. This time last year, we was going down the table,
and football was
fast as well. And football was getting worse. Players were getting worse. Performance was getting worse. And everyone was just waiting for the end of the season.
Just the atmosphere around.
Now this is one of them seasons you don't want it to end.
No. That's
you want it to carry on.
And I say the atmosphere over there last eight games is the games.
It was brilliant today.
It was great.
The bowling pub before the game was rocking.
I saw the video you put up.
Proper rocking, mate. The Pirate song went on for about an hour. Just when you thought it was stopping, someone else would start it again.
That song, though, when you get it in your head, you can't get it out, can you?
No.
Just keep going.
Should we leave it there then, boys? What were we going to talk about? We want to talk about a couple of transfers, yeah. Obviously, a couple of names being bandied about this week. Emenike, who strangely posted pictures of Green Street on
his
Instagram.
Was it Green Street?
Do you know what? That might be a wind up.
Is he the
the Nigerian striker? He's been on loan, hasn't he, in the Al Jazeera.
Someone messaged us and said the last five games he played for, whoever it was, they booed him off the pitch. He was that bad.
Oh, it fit him well at West Ham. Yeah. Everyone boos anyone for no reason.
But yeah, that's what they said about him. And his goal scoring record ain't that great, from what I've seen.
It's an extra body, though, isn't it? He's not going to be a star. But this Yilmaz that they're talking about, and there's an agent on Twitter, I can't remember his name now, but he's one of their agents. And he kept tweeting out about West Ham. And he's
his
agent.
It looks like Jelovic is on his way out as well. They were saying that Jelovic might not make it to the end of the transfer window. He's on a lot of money.
This Yilmaz, going back to him, if we get him, then he is a really good striker.
Exciting time.
Yeah, he's a really good striker. And if we get him, that would be a coup for the club.
I'd say not a rumour we began or looking at Demba Ba again. I don't know how true it was.
Well, the thing is with Demba Ba is that, don't forget, he played for Bilic at Besiktas.
Yep.
And Bilic knows how bad his knee is. So I don't think he's going to go in for him.
No, so it was just a rumour I'd seen on
internet. Yeah, these Emenike and Yilmaz rumours look true.
Yeah, he gets linked all the time with us, doesn't he? Like the Tevez one come out again. Like, I'm getting bored of that one.
Tevez has come out and said that he's not
coming back.
He left Europe to go back to South America for his family. He's 32 years old now. Why is he going to want to come back?
The only thing you'll see Tevez in will be a cameo thing.
Noble's testimony.
Yeah, you know, if he asked him, that'd be the only time you'll see him back playing in Carrow.
Yeah.
As much as it pains me, I'd love to see him back, but, you know, he's, I can't see it. Just can't see it.
No.
No, like you say, he moved back to South America for his family, so he ain't going to come back after a year.
Do you know what? Coming towards the end of the season now, and if we're like, we're sort of like, we seem to be sort of like getting them replacements for the loan players now as well, which is quite exciting. Byron's coming in, obviously, for Jenkinson. He's looking to sign a winger, and that Gokhan Touré in
would
the
be
summer
a replacement for Moses.
Would be a replacement for Moses. It's starting to become, you know, a good team to be built on in the summer, and I can see a massive signing coming in that summer, mate, and topping it all off. And I think we're going to have a fabulous start. Or we're going to get relegated.
I think with Bilic, I think we're safe under Bilic. Really safe under Bilic. I think he knows the right players to sign.
Yep.
Yeah, look, he's got
a lot of experience.
He knows.
And the thing is,
he's loved by the fans. He's loved by the players. You can tell the players love him. They love going to work.
He's still building his squad.
Yeah.
He's still building.
That's what I mean. He's still got Arthur Sands.
Do you know, sometimes I worry about him because I worry about his tactical naivety.
Because the one system.
The one system and all that. But then I look around and I look at people like Klopp, who's been there for a while now, and he hasn't put his foot down with anyone. I know they're saying it's not Klopp's team, it's not Klopp's team. That's not really Billy's team.
No.
By one or two, you know what I mean? Like,
yeah, you see, but for me, what he's done is he's took the best part of Allardyce's team
and added to it.
He improved that team.
Yeah, massively.
Just Lanzini and Payet improved that team.
But they're saying like, you know, oh, he ain't got his team, blah, blah, blah. If you can't get a game out of Benteke, you can't get the best out of Benteke. Benteke was banging him in left, right and centre for a shit Aston Villa team.
Yeah.
Yep.
And Liverpool can't get the best out of him.
And he tore Liverpool to pieces in that FA Cup semi-final as well, didn't he? Like, and he's just
be fair, I'm sure we can get the best out of him.
Liverpool this season, for me, they're not a great team.
Nah.
They're not. I don't even think they're a good team.
No.
Do you know what I mean? There's parts of their play, like, they all rave about this fucking
Albert.
They all rave about this Coutinho. I ain't seen nothing from him.
Firmino looked good today. They've got a couple of good players, but they haven't got a quality squad. But then, like you said, for Klopp now, this is a pre-season for him, isn't it?
You know what you're saying about Liverpool? I was watching Football Focus last Saturday. I forgot to say this last week. And they was doing odds on teams for winning the title. And they had, like, obviously they had, like, you know, Arsenal, City, Leicester, something like that. They even had odds for Liverpool to win the league. No, West Ham, though.
Yeah, but that's the BBC. Yeah, we don't really say they're not going to have odds on West Ham.
No, but they've got odds on Liverpool, like, ninth, tenth,
If West Ham ever won the Premier League, the BBC would stop showing matches a day. You know, let's be honest.
And Graham Souness is still be saying, careful what you wish for.
Okay. One thing I want to do mention as well before we move on is Mark Lawrence on the Knees at Mother Brown podcast this week. Did you hear it?
No, I ain't heard it yet.
And he tips us to finish in Europe.
Yeah.
We're
called
screwed.
It to him. We're like bottom three on his prediction.
Don't take it personally. I don't want you to take it personally. I don't want you to. Well, how are you going to get on this week? You probably lose. Yeah, you probably lose.
What do you have us down for?
A draw, I think. I think.
Got lucky with that one.
Like I said, they even broke the clocks twice, right? Right, twice a day.
Yeah, true.
He got one. He got
Abbott
one.
Abba dabby dung.
Yeah. I've got a great joke. Yeah, oh, I got it wrong.
Oh, gosh. Graham, you do make me laugh, mate.
But I dislike how you like dislike Richard Keys.
Yeah.
How much he winds me up.
Yeah, yeah. No, I can see that. Yeah,
he winds everyone at West Ham related.
Just a twat, isn't he?
Yeah.
I think he's just becoming. I think this is becoming a bit of a troll for him. Do you know what I mean?
Of course he is.
Like he might not have started to do this, but as it's gone on, he's sort of got picked up, and he's like,
just does it to wind something.
But that's it. It's that old scenario, isn't it? any publicity is good publicity.
Yeah.
So the more West Ham fans getting irate with him keep predicting he's going to lose, the more he's going to predict he's lose because his name's in the papers. His name's on the telly. You know, it's just the way it works.
He looks like a scruffy cunt though, doesn't he?
A scruffy cunt, that's why. Uh-huh. He asked me for a quid last night.
He does some horrendous shirts, doesn't he, on Match of the Day?
That's his haircut and he's fucking like
Stephen Penis Peanut.
That's funny. Trying so hard not to laugh.
Oh god.
Any other business? Any other news?
I don't think so. I think
good luck to my princess, Kevin Nolan at Leyton Orient.
There you go.
Winning start of day.
Do you know what? Good luck to him. I think he'll make a really good manager. I really think he'll do.
Future West Ham manager?
Nah, not future West Ham manager. I think he'll be
future Bolton manager.
He could be a future Premier League manager without a doubt.
I turned around and said to my brother-in-law that he's what Orient need. Orient seem to need that player, that person that's gonna.
That's what winds me up. I hate Orient.
But you like Nolan.
Yeah, I'm like split. I want him to do well, but I don't like Orient.
No, Ern's gone now.
Agent Nolan's going to go in and relegate him like Lomas did to Millwall.
Not there anymore.
Yeah, don't worry, he's gone. He's gone.
That's it.
Good luck.
Yeah, good luck, Kevin.
I think he'll do well there.
All right, shall we wrap it up there then, boys? Yeah, we'll finish that there. Don't forget to go and follow us on Twitter at West Ham Fan TV, facebook.com/West Ham Fan TV, www.westhamfan.tv, and we'll finish it in a normal way. Coming you eyes.
It just made Payet look normal.
I thought Payet today, as good as he played, there was a couple of times where he tried a bit too much.
Yeah, you're going to get...
There was one time where he could have put Kiyote through on the right.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
He decided to go more, try to do a step over again and lost the ball.
Yeah.
But look, I'm not going to sit here and slag him off. He's world class. And
but here's the thing. Here's the thing that you pay your money to see.
He's better than Zidane.
Exactly. Totally agree with you.
Super Slammers man. They were singing his name today, weren't they? Super Slam.
Someone's putting out a t-shirt.
Fucking hell, every week.
Dan,
get the legends range.
The thing is, we go back to Moses.
Ginger Collins one coming out soon.
If we go back to Moses, it's his fault we conceded that second goal.
Yeah.
Because he's got the ball, Creswell's gone past him on the overlap, gone through. He stops, turns around and goes backwards when there was no need to.
And also I think Collins and Reid got a bit mixed up as well.
Yeah.
But it just seemed to bounce around a lot before it fell to him.
But it was Creswell's now out of position. The ball was forward. Moses has stopped and gone backwards.
But that's the thing about Man City though, isn't it? One mistake and they're on you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
That's a sign of a team that are going for the title. And when you've got players like Aguero on the pitch, it's a privilege to see players like that in the flesh, you know what I mean?
It's what we want to see.
It's
probably what players want to play against as well.
I can't wait for him to be in the claret and blue next season at the Olympic Stadium.
I said to him, can you imagine Aguero in our side?
No. Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
That never happened to score.
Probably be sucked.
That won't happen, but, you know.
Yeah, they'll be starting up front. Yeah. But it was just a disappointment. I just felt robbed, you know what I mean? I felt a bit robbed today because I definitely felt Otamendi should have gone. And you know, 10 men's a different game. And we just had the better of them all game with 11.
If Torre gets the booking that he should have got, he's off in the second half as well.
That's the difference with this season and the last few seasons. You're coming out of there today disappointed with a 2-2 draw against Man City at home.
Taking 4 points off of them.
Yeah. I remember some of the days when they used 4 points.
Yeah, the remember days they used to be 3-0 and we wouldn't even get a sniff.
Nah.
And now we've gone to their ground.
Well, look at the Carling Cup semi-final.
Ground this season. We beat them 2-1. All right, we hold on for the second half. And then today, we could have walked out there with another 3 points.
We should have.
And I think hardcore Man City fans would have probably held their hands up and say, yeah, we deserve to win that, West Ham.
Yeah.
Not Man City, like West Ham.
We at the bar at the end, Kyoto.
And that's just great chance right at the end. Kyoto, I thought, oh, Jesus Christ, I thought, no, just that would have gone in, mate. I think the old Trevor Brooking up would have just gone collapsed over, like,
just got too much on it, didn't
he? Yeah. It was literally the last touch of the game, as soon as that went, the ref blew.
Nah, just gutted, man. But yeah, it's another point.
4 points. Yeah.
We're
disappointed.
I know Tottenham on today. We're a point off of Man United, and they were fucking shit today.
And not only that,
right,
you think
Southampton,
Charlie Austin.
But the thing is, like, it's another top team that we haven't lost again. We've done a double over Liverpool. We've beat Man City and drew at home. We've got Arsenal coming up, you know.
But again, we're starting. This is the good thing about it, right? We're starting to make this a fortress.
Yeah.
I think this is the best run of undefeated games we've had there since 97.
Mm. Redknapp days, yeah.
Yeah, since 97. I remember only losing there twice.
Well, the thing is, yeah, I think it is. The thing is, like, still going by it, Bournemouth are the last team to win at the Bowling. After we lost them first two games, I thought to myself, this is going to be this one of these seasons where we're not going to hardly win here. But we ain't lost since August, though.
That's it. Mm. That's a lot of draws, but, yeah, but at times when we was on our arse. But this is the thing.
Draw than lose.
You have City out of the way now. Got Liverpool in a cup, yeah, which no matter what happens, I want to go for the FA Cup, yeah, yep. So he should definitely put out a decent team.
But I think he will.
That's a rest from the league now.
Yeah.
And the next week, Lanzini's going to be back. The week after that, Carroll's going to be back. Mm. The week after that, Sacco's going to be back.
And we, whatever we had in the transfer
window. And whatever we had in the transfer window.
So squad available.
It's all looking cushy because, don't forget, we've got still Tottenham to play there. The last game under the lights of the Bowling, do you think they're going to lose that? Because I don't.
Well, the thing is, as well, you look at the next few league games, Southampton, they're a bit 50-50. Mm. Always a tough game there. Mm. Then you've got Aston Villa, Norwich. You know, they're games that we can win.
Of course they are. They're all winnable games.
If we
win, winnable games.
We're in touching distance. Yeah. When these players start coming back, we get our full squad back. If they all stay fit, of course, you don't know what happens.
Yeah, yeah.
In an ideal world, though. You know, this is this is what's going to help us as well. The last games at the Bowling, we're down to the last eight games at the Bowling now. Eight games left, right? They're not going to want to lose here.
No.
It's gonna start creeping into their mind now, right? We ain't lost here since August.
Yep.
Let's fucking get this season and let's make sure we do not lose here again to anybody, right?
But then that could work the other way.
Yeah, that's
it's on their mind. You don't want to lose.
I think once you get into that frame of mind and you're undefeated, you've got a streak of confidence as well. Yeah, and you've had, you know.
I think if we can get past Liverpool in the Cup, I think there's nothing stopping us this season.
There's nothing stopping us anyway. No, we can still break into that top six, five.
I think
I think top four is a bit too much.
We've got to play Spurs, though.
Liverpool.
We've got to play Spurs, but I'm just saying, I don't think they'll be top four either. But I'm just saying.
I think they will.
Liverpool's going to be a tough game next week. You know, I know we've done the double over them and we seem to have their number this season, but it's going to be a tough game. I hope we don't lose. I don't think we were. I'm confident we're going to
I've got a feeling. But I've got a feeling we're going to pull them back, yeah.
After watching Liverpool last couple of games, like especially today, they won 5-4 against Norwich.
They're weak at set pieces.
Yeah, they're weak everywhere.
Four goals against Norwich.
They're weak everywhere.
You know, the only decent defender they've got, Sacco.
We could go up. Yeah, and that says it all.
Yeah,
we could go up there next week and another 3-0 win.
Of course we could.
Easy.
We just. I'd be more confident if we had Lanzini and Carroll available. I'm still confident.
But then the week after that, we will have.
Yeah.
I sound like fucking. What's his name? Denzel Washington. Yeah. No, not Denzel Washington. Jay-Z.
Yeah, yeah.
It is exciting. It's exciting. You can't remember this. I'm naked, mate. You can't remember this time. I can't remember this time I've been that excited getting towards the end of the season. Apart from.
I got excited at Christmas last year and then we dropped off. This season it doesn't look like
and
we're letting up.
That's the difference. This time last year we was going down the table.
And football was
fast
worse,
as well. And football was getting worse. Players were getting worse. Performance was getting worse. And everyone was just waiting for the end of the season.
Just the atmosphere around the
Now, this is one of them seasons you don't want it to end.
No.
That's you it. Want it to carry on.
And I say the atmosphere over there last eight games is the games.
It was brilliant today.
It was great.
It was brilliant today.
The Bowling pub before the game was rocking.
I saw the video you put up.
Proper rocking, mate. I didn't. The Piat song went on for about an hour. Just when you thought it was stopping, someone else just started again.
That song, though, when you get it in your head, you can't get it out, can you?
Yeah, I know. But
but
he should have had two yellow cards anyway.
Yeah. Yeah, he should have been booked for that.
There was a couple of times, even one when he went up studs up and he got Kyoto.
Mm.
He couldn't handle
today. That was the thing. And that's the only way he tried to handle him, by manhandling him.
Trying to put him out of the game, I thought.
Good penalty. Yeah, good finish.
It was a great, I mean, he's never going to miss that, is he? Let's be honest, he's too good to miss that. Anyway, come back out again. I thought they had a little bit of a spell after that before the penalty. And then we come out again, all guns blazing. I think the rest of the half, I thought we was the better side.
Yeah, I can't remember too many clear cuts. Oh, the only one I remember was the free kick.
No, the Aguero.
Aguero before the penalty.
Oh,
post.
Oh, mate. I thought he'd done it. I called
chest down.
But then that was Adrian as well. Adrian done that a couple of times today. He rushed out.
Yeah.
Without talking to his defenders.
Do you know what I think he was trying to do? I think he was trying to psych him out. I think he was trying to rush then retreat.
Yeah, but, no, unlucky from Aguero. Yeah. If that had gone in, you'd have had to applaud that.
It just hit the post and just dropped. Yeah. And then there's Reid like chasing it back, and he's just sitting there thinking, are him and Adrian on the same wavelength? And luckily enough, they were. Yeah. But it just shows the confidence in the players that Reid's got that confidence to chest it to his goalkeeper on the fucking goal line.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, and he knows his goalkeeper's going to be there.
But hang on, we've missed something out. Sam Byram coming on.
No, that was after. That was before the penalty, the chip. It was before the penalty, weren't it?
Yeah, he went off after post. The goal. Cause
James sorry, I thought he was on about.
Anyway, Jenkinson gets injured, goes down. I don't know what happened to him.
It looked like a knee problem.
Do you know what it looked like?
For me, it looked like he could have carried on.
Yeah, at one point. I exactly said that to him because he went over to the side and it looked like Bilic was getting a sub on. I was going, hold on a minute, he's all right. He got up and he was like, looked a bit confused, but I think that's just his face. I don't think it was like...
always looks knackered to me. Like,
but he ran off.
He did have a slight limp.
A slight limp, Scott. Yeah.
But the thing is, you don't know if he's tweaked a knee.
We'll see anyway, won't we?
Without a track record, next run he probably wouldn't have took his leg.
Do you honestly want to know what I think? I don't think he fancied it.
I think he was up for it. I said, I do think he was injured.
I was quite pleased he started, to be honest.
So was I.
I said the same thing.
I'd rather have had him today than Tompkins at right back, just for their pace.
Exactly.
No, it was a shame he went off, but Sam Byram come on, and he didn't look out of place.
To be fair.
2 minutes he was on that pitch, and he chested it down and smashed it 40 yards to Payet's chest. And that's confidence.
Well, it was it? Payet smashed it in 40 yards, didn't he? Yeah. And he just took it, bosh. I don't think he done anything wrong, Sam Byram, today.
Not at all.
No.
He didn't look totally right. Agree. He stepped up, and you're stepping up from Michael Dubry.
About 20 years ago.
Whoever, but. And then now you're marking Sergio Aguero.
Not a bad debut to make, is it?
He would have probably been. Earlier this season or last season, we'd probably been marking Antonio.
Yeah, true. Yeah.
I mean, you got two championship, like ex-championship players, down that right and that first and second half, and they didn't do nothing wrong.
No.
I thought Antonio, but going back to Byram, I mean, looks even to looking at one day. I mean, Everton fans are going to have a fucking feel. Like, they're going to be crying in their cornflakes tomorrow, I think. But. Oh, let's talk. Do you know what? Let's talk about a little bit about what's been said in the week with the Everton fans before we move on to the games, because we're talking about Sam Byram. Martinez coming out and saying, "What did he say? He weren't the player for us."
Well, look, this is what sums it up with Everton. Everton were in for him. Their fans were on Twitter going, "Oh yeah, we've signed him. Sam Byram this, Sam Byram that."
Because I'm
chose us, which he was always going to do if we come in for him. And now all Everton fans are saying we didn't want him. He would have just been a backup. Blah, 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 blah. Ogbonna would have been a backup. Payet would have been a backup.
The biggest load of bollocks I've ever heard in my life.
Their fans are getting worse than Spurs. I don't know what their problem is lately. They're obviously a club that's always going to be in Liverpool's shadow. They see a club like us moving on to things. And they don't like it.
New stadium.
Players coming to us. You know? Fuck Everton. Everton really fucking doing my head in lately.
You look at the transfers of old, the players that have gone there chose there over us. You know, we had Toure, Yelovich.
They keep banging on about Lukaku.
Do you know what it is? I'll be honest with you, I know exactly what it is. They were a massive club. They were a massive club back in the 80s, yeah? They were massive. I get reminded every day on Twitter now, 9 league titles.
So was Michael Jackson, but he's dead now. Fuck it, we're not in the 80s no more. Liverpool were big in the 70s and 80s.
No, yeah, but this is what I'm about to say. That was massive, right? Now, they probably had a state-of-the-art ground at the time. You know, tons of league titles, tons of FA Cups and all this, winning trophies and all that. Since 95, when they scraped a trophy against Man United, luckily at Wembley, since the 80s, they've just got a decline now. Let's be honest, they've got a chairman with no money, they've got a ground that's falling apart, and then they see someone like us, who traditionally have been seen below them, sort of like advancing, got a brand new stadium. Even they say Upton Park's better than him. Yeah, it's better than their ground, and we're knocking it down.
Yeah.
Shows you how far we're getting forward instead of them. And they just can't take it. They can't take that people would think we're a better club now. You know what I mean? But you know, the same would be said about Leeds and
every club has their period.
Forest,
Like Leeds were big in the 60s.
Ipswich won European Cups and fucking Forest. Derby, Forest. Aston Villa won a European. Honest,
Chelsea were poor until Abramovich came in.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. You know what I mean?
Preston have got league titles. Division league titles.
Yeah,
it doesn't mean nothing.
The eighties are 30 years ago now. Get over it. Stop wearing shoulder pads and pulling out them massive mobile phones and move into the 2000s.
No, that is just Liverpool.
Yeah. Anyway,
honestly, like a lot of clubs, they keep going on about, oh, we're getting a new shiny stadium. So what? So fuck you. I'm not being funny, but they're going on about their taxes. But no, Scouser pays taxes, so they're not paying. They're not paying for our stadium.
We're going to get comments.
I will get comments because I'm fed up with all these people and all these fans always going on about us. Any club, Man City have been in their stadium since 2003.
They had a similar deal to us.
Who's been saying anything to them?
Like we've said on many occasions,
don't worry about us.
Yeah. Forget about us. Thank Barry Earn and Tottenham. For the tax.
Yeah, we wanted to pay it, mate. We were happy to buy it.
Exactly. So thank them too. They fucked it up.
Fed up.
Get over people it. Always.
We could have been away by then. And then second goal, I couldn't believe it. I thought play had stopped.
Yeah.
That's God's honest truth. Because
quick thinking good, from Antonio.
Great quick thinking from Antonio. Brilliant quick thinking. A great throw as well. Yeah. I mean, that's as good as a.
And not only that, it was good of Valencia to get his body in front of the defender to not make him get the ball.
Valencia was.
And that was a good finish.
Yeah.
I don't remember the last time I see a goal from a throw-in.
No.
I don't think I ever have.
We haven't had a player that can sling a ball like that.
These throw-ins are better than corners, isn't they?
Mm.
They're better than crosses, aren't they?
Yeah.
He gets so much power and spin on them.
Our corners don't.
Because the thing is, it's not like he just loops them up into the air.
What Rory Delap used to do for pace and power.
Yeah, but that's all they used to do. They used to play for throw ones, man. They used to piss me off.
Yeah, but the thing is, like, if you've got someone that can do that and whip it in,
but it's all right when you get a throw in and it can be done, but not play for them, right? Not like fucking chip them into touch like fucking rugby players and open.
Be fair, Delap used to, if no matter what side of the pitch it was on, he'd take the throw. At least with us, it's only when they're on Antonio's side.
Yeah.
I suppose if we're chasing a goal towards the end of a game, he may then take it from another side. But
and another great finish as well. Yeah. It was nice and cool. He took his time.
Well, like Ryan said, he used his body in front.
Yeah.
I'm surprised the ref didn't blow up for a free kick.
I'll be honest with you.
I'm surprised.
I think that was the best game I've seen him in the West Ham shirt.
Valencia. I totally agree.
Yeah, he played really well.
Another two guys. Four goals in three games. Never scored a year before he scored for Bournemouth.
Mm. Yeah. But
then that's all they need, a bit of confidence, and that'll do him a world of good today.
That's fantastic, isn't it? Because you know, he stepped up when the others are out, and now they're coming back. The future's still good for us, man. I'm telling you what, we're in the distance. We're in touching distance. If we can, as I said before, we'll talk about this at the end transfers, but it looks like we've got another couple of players coming in.
Which is good.
Yeah, just for cover and just for backup and different options, which I think is a fantastic.
Well, one striker we're linked with, we get him. I don't see him being a backup. I can see him being our main striker.
Emenike.
No, Yilmaz.
Yilmaz. I'm hearing Emenike.
That's who I heard him.
Yeah, but we'll talk about that at the end anyway. But 2-2. We was controlling the game.
2-1.
2-1. Sorry, we was controlling the game.
Yeah.
Give the ending away now.
Ruin the film. But the thing is, like I said, with Aguero,
that's the sign of
a world-class striker, when you can be quiet for 20-30 minutes, not do nothing, and then bang.
I didn't see it properly, but it looked lucky to me.
Yeah,
before we talk about that, I want to talk about the substitution.
As I said to you when he made it, I do not
Antonio
understand.
Antonio calls Clichy it was Kolarov, wasn't it, right back? He calls him all sorts of problems. He had another fantastic game. I was saying to him, he's looking more and more like a Premier League player every week.
He's improving every week.
Yeah, and I didn't think he had that in him.
No.
But I was too quick to judge him. I said, he's not going to learn that. He's not going to learn that. And every week he looks stronger and stronger and stronger. And
he looked like the player who we signed.
Yeah, he just was hassling them. Yeah. all game.
Didn't give him a chance,
didn't give him a sniff, didn't give him anything, right? And after 65 minutes, he brings him off and brings Moses on.
See, I thought it was the right decision to bring Moses on, because I thought with his pace,
he
had a good game at City earlier in the season. He's just come back. I thought, but then taking Antony off at that time was a bit too early for me. But I did want Moses on to cause them problems with his
pace. For me, he strolled around and done fuck all.
Yeah, but
When Moses came on, we were playing with 10 men.
Yeah, he didn't.
He strolled around and done nothing.
He was the other week.
Yeah, a bit like that. He's another one.
He weren't as bad as Zerati, but he just was.
He had a couple of good runs and that. But
he didn't want to know when he lost the ball.
Nah.
We're tracking back.
He jogged back.
But against City, that's what you need. That's what you need. He should have come on for the last 10.
Yeah, that was it. I think he'd come on 10 minutes too early for me. Looking at it in hindsight, like before we saw how he performed when he came on. Like you said, you would have brought him on, but it would have been last 20, last 15.
Do you know what I would have done as well? I know he had to chuck Jelovic on at the end just to give us a different option and whatever, but I would have taken... Noble done a lot of work in there today. He done a lot of work in there. Done some good stuff, some not-so-good stuff. I would have just taken him off and put Obiang on just for that no-nonsense approach to it. Do you know what I mean? Like, Noble, as much as the good work he does, sometimes he gets a bit carried away with it. You know what I mean? Because he's a fan, I think when, like, the tackles are... Do you agree with me? Yeah. When the tackles are flying, he wants to get to everything.
Yeah.
And, like, he ain't got the body to get to everything. He ain't got the ability to get to him, but he wants to.
Yeah.
And that's great, but I would have just... Let's slow it down now. Let's calm it down. Keep hold of the ball. I think
Obiang would have been a good player to bring in into that middle.
Yeah.
You know, just to solidify that middle up.
Yeah. Because Alex Song wasn't letting anything get past him.
No. As you said, he was immense.
I'll tell you what today's game was screaming out for: Andy Carroll.
Oh, yeah. Mate. Yeah. We said that. Yeah.
Without a doubt. I was sitting there thinking to myself. If he was there or on that bench, bringing him on with 10 minutes ago, we'd have won that game.
The ball Byron put in the first half. Just missed like Valencia. The ball Noble put in the second half. The one, was it Antonio or headed it wide? They're the chances that Carroll screamed out.
He screamed out for
you.
You
put that on to Carroll, it's a goal. 9 times out of 10, it's a goal.
We'd just clean everyone out to get to it, wouldn't he?
Yeah, he'd probably even give him free kicks against the fucking referee today. You know, money out the smell one of their farts, and he would have been given free. You know what I mean? It's fucking ridiculous.
I can't remember any more chances. The only one was right at the end.
We didn't talk about Aguero's goal though.
Delphi the post.
I thought that was a bit lucky though. I felt Adrian had it covered as well. Yeah. I didn't think.
Yeah, it didn't hit the post clean. It sort of clipped the post. Yeah. So that weren't.
But for me though, see, the amount of time all Man City were doing was going long over the top to Aguero.
One thing as well, Winston Reid's tackle on De Bruyne, when De Bruyne went through and Reid got back, and that was a great tackle. He played really well today. I think he's cemented his spot back in that team now. It's just out of Ogbonna and Collins.
But Collins didn't put a foot wrong today.
The only thing I worry about with Collins is someone like Aguero. I thought he was going to give a lot of free kicks away today. But fair play to him. He got stuck in.
Won every header.
Yeah, just typical Ginger Pele this season.
We've got 4 decent centre halves now.
Yeah.
You know, so there's good cover.
Payet was class.
So I'm saying, Payet.
He took the fight.
That's the thing.
There was £50 million men on the pitch, and he outshone every single one of them.
Apart from
Alex Song.
This is the thing. He was good. He had a good game, but Song was so good.
Having dig at our club, they need to worry about their own club.
And at the end of the day, I'm paying for that ground. You're paying for that ground. You're paying for that ground. So we're paying for it as well.
Mm.
So
we're taxpayers.
Exactly.
Anyway, he had a good debut.
Very good.
Really good debut. And I'm pleased.
Yep.
I'm so pleased. He looked like he'd been playing there for years. I don't think. Do you know what I liked about him today? Is he never? Any time he felt pressured, he went back to Collins.
Yep.
Anytime. You know, he was a bit under a bit of pressure. He played the way he was facing. He didn't try nothing fancy, apart from that outrageous 40-yard ball.
But he still pulled it off.
That's what I'm saying. But he tried nothing fancy. He looked so comfortable there.
The thing for me is,
I'm looking forward to seeing him in the future.
Yeah,
I think we could see him start.
I think so.
The next league game. Can he? I don't think he can play in the FA Cup, can he?
He might not be able to.
No, I think he played for Leeds. But the next league game could start.
I don't think Jenkinson might not get a look in there.
Well, you know, if he's injured, he's going to be out for a few weeks.
Mm. The thing is with Jenks, I don't know what's happening with that, because we obviously played Arsenal 1.5 million up front for him. And now they want to take him back, but they won't give us half the money back, which is fair. We might as well keep him. Yeah, I don't understand what that deal is, but it wouldn't surprise me if he goes back to Arsenal.
Please, if he
I'll give Byron a couple more weeks to see.
Yeah, you've got until the end of obviously January.
And the problem is,
he can go back any time, can't he?
Probably, yeah.
Loan deal, yeah.
But the problem we've got again is the depth, isn't it? You know, if we send Jenks back and Tompkins injuries.
Yeah.
Well, according to Bilic, Jenks ain't going nowhere, so.
So just keep him there. You know, it's a good backup to have. If Byron does hit the ground running as he has this today.
Let's be honest, he's not a backup to Byron, is he? Byron should be a backup to him.
But that's it. If Byron now hits a bit of form, keep playing him.
Yeah,
these are exciting times. Anyway, end of the first half. I mean, there was nothing really happened for the rest of it, did it?
Yeah,
happened.
Yeah, yeah. World class safe and free kick.
Oh god, yeah, I forgot. About. Oh fucking hell, I forgot about the sending off. I forgot about everything. Hold on a minute. Yeah. So, a couple minutes later, someone puts the ball through. Was it Payet? Put the ball through to him, or was it Song?
Song, I think.
I think Song put it through to Antonio. Antonio's knocked it past Otamendi.
Clear in the corner. If I remember rightly, Man City had a corner, weren't it?
Yeah, maybe.
And it was on the counter attack. And the ball's, we've played the ball out from the back, it's gone through to Antonio.
Anyway, yeah, he's played it through to Antonio. Antonio's knocked it past on Mendy, threw on goal, brings him down.
Yep.
What happened? Referee bottled it.
Yeah.
Absolutely bottled it. And I think, to be honest with you, today, right, and I'm not just saying this about because I'm bitter or whatever, you know what I mean? A point against Man City is a great point.
Yep.
But I feel robbed by him, because he was fucking awful, that referee.
He bowled a lot of decisions today. Like I said, Toure should have had two yellow cards today.
Yep.
Yeah. Easy.
I think the standard referee has been poor all season, in general, not just our games, in general.
Like, when he booked Noble for that challenge, Noble got the ball.
Yeah,
exactly.
But that's what I'm saying, like, you bring him down, last man, booking. And Byron got booking for fuck all as well.
So his second foul, he got booked.
Yeah.
Mm.
And I'm sure Toure made four or five, more before he got booked.
That Byron one, I turned around to the boat next to me and I said, he'd have got away with that in the Championship. That's the difference between Championship football and Premier League football. You can't get away with that, but he's still never been booked.
It's just that I think it was a disgraceful referee. Yeah, I think the linesman was the same.
You saw the linesman on our side.
Wouldn't give anything.
He hesitated every time to give a decision. Mm. And probably... But after decisions he gave were the wrong decision. He was absolutely awful. And they said the referee was no better.
I just think it's been awful this year.
That
Premier League
quiet free kick though, Joe Hart, what a save. I thought we hit the crossbar at first from where I was sitting, because I'm behind that goal, and it looked like the crossbar when I see the replay.
That was such a great save. And then he done one just after that where someone crossed it and it was dropping to Valencia's feet, and he scooped it out and made sure it went.
He gets his critics, but he's a world class goalkeeper.
I wouldn't call him a world class goalkeeper.
He's the best we've got in this country.
Best we've got in the country, without a doubt.
I know you say like he has his moments,
but what goalkeeper don't then?
You know, he pulls off
some De Gea has his moments.
World class saves.
And he's world class. Everyone says he's world class. Yeah. Lloris, everyone says he's world class. He has his moments.
Like Scott said, you know, 9 times out of 10 you make a mistake in goal, it's in the back of the net. So he might make one mistake, but...
I don't know. Sometimes I just think he gets a little bit... It looks like to me he's showing off too much sometimes.
He's big-headed, doesn't he?
Yeah.
That's his problem.
And that's when he starts to... So he's been dropped for Man City for doing that sort of thing. He just gets a bit above himself, bit confident, bit cocky.
It's the same when you go back to when he was playing for England under 21s. We're in the semi-final, he's penalty shootout.
Yeah,
you know, he gets booked and gets suspended for the final for, you know, doing things he shouldn't be doing, just getting there and getting on with the game.
Mm.
You know, and it's just that is it. He thinks he's a bit above himself.
Yeah.
And lets himself down.
Mm.
But you see that with some players quite a lot.
Don't get me wrong, he's a very good goalkeeper. But I wouldn't call him world class, because I've seen world class goalkeepers like Buffon.
That was world class.
And you've never seen them make mistakes.
Not really. Not like him.
They all make mistakes.
Buffon, I think, was a different level as a goalkeeper.
I mean,
that's world class.
Yeah, he was a different level to a lot of goalkeepers. Like Buffon,
he didn't make many mistakes. I mean, one or two in his career.
Like all his career, he was, you know, number one at Madrid in Spain. Like, and he, you know, last couple of seasons, he's been dropping a few.
Yeah, then Real Madrid were slating him, calling him shit.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
No, I wouldn't say he was world class. Sorry to disagree with you, mate.
We've all got opinions. I think Joe Hart is a good goalkeeper.
Yeah, very good goalkeeper. But so that was it for the first half.
If you look at Arsenal,
have I missed anything?
No, that's it. But you look at that though. If it weren't for him and the poor referee decision,
but that is, you know, that's where a goalkeeper can come into. You know, he was very good today. I think Adrian wasn't at his best. He done things right, but he said he made a few rash decisions today when he could have stayed on his line. Like, it could have cost us, but it didn't. But you know, I'm never going to have a go at Adrian because he saves us so many times.
He didn't really have a lot to do in the
first half,
did he?
Not a great amount. No, yeah. I don't remember him making a save.
No, I can't.
When
you look at the chances, they had the penalty and then the one hit the post in the first half. But I can't remember him having to pull off a save.
They didn't have
all
any like clear cut chances, did they?
Yeah, so second half, come out in the same manner. Just absolutely bombarding them, just chance after chance after chance. Didn't, what I would say in the first half, we didn't make our chances count enough against them. You know, as you said, they did keep, but, you know. Hello everyone and welcome back to another edition of West Ham Fan TV's Post-Match Pint, the only West Ham United post-match full show on the internet. We've just been to the West Ham Man City game. It's West Ham 2, Manchester City 2. Boys, that was so fucking close. Too close.
Yeah.
We was unlucky. Really unlucky. Let's go for the starting lineup.
I must admit, I've never walked away being disappointed with a draw.
Especially against St. Not Man City.
What happens when you draw against like Exeter then? You disappointed or not?
It's us, isn't it? I'm used to that.
Hang on, Graham's going to come out of a stat now from about 10 years ago.
I believe in that. I think it's about 1933, I think. Yeah, anyway.
Well done, Graham. Oxford.
Let's go through the starting lineup. Jenkinson out. Jenkinson plays instead of Tompkins. Tompkins was out, wasn't he?
I felt a bit sorry for Ogbonna that he got dropped today.
Yeah, I was the same as well.
I was a bit surprised, but Reid and Collins looked solid today.
Yeah, Reid stepped in. Oh,
the God. Wet wipe.
Jesus, man. That guy was class today.
Yeah, he did play well.
That was absolute top class.
It was the Alex Song of the first half.
Yeah.
He had his swagger back. You see it? He just bossed the whole game.
David Tillman, I've got a sniff.
And good as well. I was worried about him today because he always plays well against West Ham.
Yeah.
Who else? Jelovic kept it. Valencia kept his place up front, and I thought to myself, I'll be honest, when I saw that team who's coming in, I thought, oh, we're going to have no distribution again, no one to hold up the ball.
See, I was different when I see the starting lineup and I see Valencia up front. I thought, yeah, that's a good decision. I thought it'd have been better playing Jelovic up front.
It's just the way Valencia played last week.
That's because he was non-existent last week.
Yeah, but then everyone was. I don't think he could have made like wholesale changes. You know, it just maybe one or two players.
It's because of his touch as well.
Yeah,
you know what I mean. It's
his touch was awful last week.
It's been awful all the time. But fucking hell, he stepped up today. Let's go through the game then. Starts off a cracking start, like a firecracker. We come out the traps. We were saying last week, we've got to come out of the traps, we've got to come out of the traps, we've got to come out of the traps. Jesus Christ, couldn't come out of the traps any quicker.
What was it, about 30, 40 seconds?
45 seconds, yeah.
55, they said on.
It's the second fastest goal of the Premier League.
Is it?
Yeah.
I
don't know whether that's altogether or that's this season.
Probably this season, I think someone's got about 18 seconds before, didn't they?
It was quick.
But it was really fast. We come out of the traps, man.
Scored a few goals this year, though, in quite a few games.
No, but I think sometimes we get, you know, there's been a lot of times this season where we just don't start. Last week was a prime example. Mm-hmm. We just didn't start last week. We found ourselves 2-0 down before we got out of the changing room.
Yep.
Yeah, but when you take it in context of the rest of the season, last week was a one-off. I mean, it was just a poor game from everyone.
I think we've had a couple of games. I wouldn't say it's a one-off. It's just another one of them kicks up the arse.
We've had games like that this season, but we've come back in it.
The Watford game.
No, we was bad, but you can't take it away from Newcastle last week. They was just decent in the start. They weren't great, but they was decent.
They started really well last week. Yeah. Like we said, we just didn't come out of the dressing room.
No. Yeah. But that's what I was a bit worried about, because I was thinking to myself, you know, you don't come out of the dressing room this week, you're going to find yourself 3 or 4 nil down by the time.
They had to be up against City today, and they was straight from kick-off, and then 1-0 up, couldn't ask for a better start. Joe Hart should have done better.
For a goal? Yeah, I said that.
Should have done better.
It come at him fast, though. So. Yeah. It come at him quick.
But great, Valencia in the right position.
Yeah, he dropped off well as well. I thought, you know, that's a touch of a good player when you can anticipate that it's going to, you know, that's a bit of anticipation. He knew someone was in the back post. He wasn't sliding in on the front. He was sort of like dropped back just in case.
Yeah.
And, you know, it dropped to him and lovely finish. Yeah. I thought, lovely, beautiful finish first
great,
time.
Great little run by Kyoto.
Yeah, and that
he burst into the box. I think Song made the tackle.
That's him of old, though, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
But that's what Song gives him.
I was just about to say, did you notice the difference with them three in the middle today? Noble, Kiole and Song.
I said to you, Noble's better when he's got them players alongside him and he's got Song alongside him because he can get on with his...
I've been saying that since the opening day of the season.
When you look back at that game, you see Song, he sits He sits just in front of the back four and behind them two.
Yeah.
And he allows them two to get forward.
He was world class today.
Yeah. Outstanding. No absolutely outstanding.
Bones about it, mate. He was world class. He was back to... the very best Alex Song, Arsenal Alex Song.
Yeah.
He was world class today. I was thinking, like, because Payet had a real good game as well. And I was thinking to myself, the sponsor's going to give him it.
Hmm.
But he
stepped up.
No, so we come out, 1 minute in, we're dominating the game. Hmm. I think, to be honest, I think we dominated the whole thing.
Yeah.
The whole thing from first minute to... They had spells, but they're going to have spells. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? They've got some... that Aguero, we talk about him, he's just an enigma, he is. He's just... He's a different class.
He's a great player. I think he's the best player in the Premier League.
I'd agree with that. He just does things that, like... You know, some of the things he gets to shouldn't be getting there. Do you know what I mean? Like the way he takes it round players and
He always looks like he's injured all the time. Yeah. The way he just strolls around. But listen, great players score goals and win your games and rescue your points.
The thing is, you take him out of that side today. They didn't really pose a threat.
I thought we done well today. We kept Kevin De Bruyne and Silva very quiet. Mm. Yaya Toure. We sort of kept him quiet, but he still made things happen.
Mm. But that's the difference, though. Them players, that's quality players, and to keep the two of them quiet.
Yeah.
You know,
we controlled the game up to the moment, and the penalty. I mean,
where I was sitting, it looked like a shoulder barge. From where I was sitting in the booking up, I was far away. It looked like it was just. But someone told me that he jinxed.
Yeah, our first reaction from where we were sitting, it looked like he took the ball.
Mm.
Yeah. But then it filtered through that it was a penalty.
Yeah,
it
took him.
Mm.
It was unfortunate.
It was given. But maybe it was one of them ones that may be given, maybe not given. I don't know.
Like you say, if it had been us down the other end, would you have been screaming for a penalty?
Yeah.
Yeah, probably, but.
To be fair, on that display from the referee today, if it was us down the other end, he wouldn't have given it.
No. I was just about to say that. What do you make the referee? I thought
surprised that Yaya Toure, it took that long for him to get booked. Was in the 86th minute,
wasn't
it?
That tackle.
The one when he brought down Kyoto, yeah.
He should have walked.
He shouldn't have walked.
He should have had a yellow.
From what I've heard on the replay, he should have walked.
No, he had players behind him. He wasn't the last man.
No, it was just the way he went in.
The way he went in from behind.
I didn't think it was that bad.
I didn't see
Noble get sent off for less.